And now we're here with the beautiful Callie Hawk from Fox's widely popular show, New Girl.
Hey.
So, first of all, how are you?
Excellent. Now that I'm sitting here with you, I love your jacket.
So kind. Okay, so from the season finale of last season, your character Shelby and Winston had a very interesting epiphany about each other. Now, can you tell us what's going to be happening in the next few episodes of season two?
Well, where we left Winston and Shelby, they were still together, very much in love and very much aware of the fact that they are in love with each other. So
he followed you.
Yeah.
On your trip.
And I tried to come back to him, and he was where I was and I was where he's supposed to be. So we definitely know that we love each other. How that's gonna go season two, I guess that's what you kind of have to look out for.
You can't give us any hint if there's gonna be some serious...
Well, saying I love you is pretty serious, but as you know, that's just the beginning. Like, I think a lot of times girls are like, oh my God, you wanna get the guy to say that he loves you. But then once people say that they love each other, well, now you have to do it. And that's kind of the hard part. So that's kind of where the adventure begins for Winston and Shelby. They're almost kind of like, I think of them like, have you ever seen Cheers?
Mm-hmm.
They're like the new generation Sam and Diane. Will they? Won't they? How's it going to happen? They're so different, but they're so alike.
I think they're going to. That's just my personal opinion because I'm a big fan of the show and I really want to see you guys together and both of you to make that commitment. But also I want to talk about is the In Living Color reboot.
Yeah.
So can you tell us about that? Are the Wayans brothers also involved? And
yeah.
Who are you playing? What can you tell us?
Well, you can't think In Living Color without thinking about the Wayans. So definitely you've got Keenan at the helm, and it's at Fox where it started out about 25 years ago. So it's really exciting to be a part of something that has that long legacy. A lot of great stars have come from In Living Color, the first installment. So it's really super fun. I mean, you can definitely expect a lot of laughs, a lot of wild and crazy sketches. We shot a lot of stuff. So it'll be even exciting for me to see which things they pick to air.
So you're already done shooting?
Yeah, we shot a couple of specials, and they're supposed to air sometime this fall, but I don't know exactly when. So
we're going to be having to look out for it in fall.
Yes.
Okay, it's just so crazy because that show was so popular, and it had, you know, our older generation as their demographic. And now with you, this young hot star on New Girl, it's going to bring a whole new demographic. It's just, I have a feeling it's going to be a huge hit. So congratulations.
Thank you so much. It's really fun to think about how many people that show touched. Because our parents liked it, or if you had an older brother or something, they really liked it. But they show those reruns now.
All the time.
And when we sit down and watch it, it's still funny, and it's still just as crazy as it was then. It's almost kind of crazy to think, like, the stuff they got away with back then. You almost can't do that now. Like, the men on film, they're two, like, very flamboyantly homosexual guys, just kind of, like, just throwing out every stereotype they can in a way that's so loving and so accepting, people really loved it. Whereas now, that would be so un-PC, you would not be able to put that on television. And those are two iconic characters that people really still like. So it'll be neat to see how people receive some of that edgy humor and if there's still room for it and if people are still, if people have become more sensitive or less sensitive in the past 25 years.
Hopefully less, but I have a feeling...
I hope less. Yeah. I mean, it's comedy. Come on.
Okay, and since I love the Wayans brothers, they can do no wrong in my eyes.
That's how I feel.
The best. Can you tell if they're going to make a cameo, or will we see them on the show?
Well, I will say that it's exactly how it was the first time. So there were Wayans then...
So
I guess it would be
you don't have to tell us everything, but that's great news. Okay.
You can't have In Living Color without the Wayans.
I know, but I was hoping that they weren't just going to be producing and writing, so we'll see those cute little faces.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, good. And then also, you have a movie coming out. Two movies coming out. So, Tyler Perry. Everyone knows Tyler Perry.
Yep.
You're in We the Peoples. Can you tell us about your role in that?
We the Peoples, that's with Kerry Washington, who is one of my favorite people ever. I actually was looking at a magazine. We were both featured in this magazine, and it had
names.
It was called Black Men's Magazine, where I guess they feature, you know, different actresses, and, you know, they try to use whatever the hottest pictures are of us that they can find, because usually we're trying to keep everything covered up. But they find, like, the most glamorous and hot pictures of their favorite
actresses.
Maxim? Kind of like that, but
But you don't know that they're putting those pictures in.
Well, I've seen the magazine. Like, I saw it, and I didn't even know that Kerry was in it. And then when I saw it, they had Zoe Saldana, Kerry Washington, me, God, there were a few other people in there. I'm trying to think of all the names. But when I saw Kerry Washington's name on there, I was like, oh my God, I just love her. Like, I hope one day I get to do a movie with her. And a month later, I got cast as her sister in We the Peoples. So when That's we were doing crazy. The movie, I told her that. She was like, oh my God, things like that do happen. I was like, I know, they happened to me.
And she saw the magazine too. So she's yeah. probably like, who's this beautiful girl?
We definitely did not know each other before. But once we did the movie, we became really close. It's about a family called the Peoples family. And like most families, we have our own way of doing things, our own culture, if you will. And when outsiders come, it's kind of, it's a jarring experience trying to have those two things existing in one space. So it's very like a meet the parents in a way. Kerry is dating Craig Robinson from The Office, and he is eager to join the culture of the Peoples family. And it's a lot more daunting than he would have expected.
Because your family is crazy, or what can you tell us about the family?
I think everyone's family is kind of crazy, but like most crazy families, they don't think they are. They think that they're normal. So like my family, I think my family is crazy, but if you were to ask them, they would be like, no, we're normal. Like, this is how you're supposed to do stuff. Like, really? They're not doing this other places.
Okay, so then Tyler Perry.
Yes,
is he in it? Because I know sometimes he's in it, sometimes he's not.
Well, he's starring in so many movies that...
He's all over the place. Is he the busiest man alive?
I think it's cool, though, because sometimes people make excuses like, oh, I can't do this, or this can't be done. He's like, oh, no, it can be done. I'm doing it. So he's just inspiring. Just think about his career and where it started and where it is now. He's like a leading man in movies. So I've seen the trailer for his new Alex Cross movie. Now he's like a leading man action star.
I couldn't believe that.
It was a really good trailer. I was like, holy crap.
No, I definitely want to see that. Thank you so much for being with us. You seriously are so beautiful. And I love the career choices you're making. And I hope to keep seeing you in my favorite shows and in new movies and in the magazines.
I feel so like, I'm going to cry. Oh my God.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Congratulations on everything.
Thank you, and thanks for having me on
the show. I'm loving the new season of Your Girl. Best ever.
Bye.